इंटरनेट आता हूँ।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
ओके वी विल वेट फॉर 5 मोर मिनट बिकॉज यू नो आवर स्टार्टिंग टाइम इज 11, सो लेट्स वेट फॉर सम टाइम। ओके टिल दैट टाइम आई विल डू सम टेस्टिंग ऑफ माय वीडियो, बट माय साउंड इज गुड राइट? यू कैन हियर मी वेल?
यस सर।
यस सर। एंड गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
What's this, sir?
Yeah, I'm going to explain you everything today. All right. Okay, but your video is okay? You can see very clearly?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
We can see our video. We have to on our video, sir.
Yeah, if you like, I would like to see you as well. Yeah, I can see the known faces. Sorry? Okay, let's wait. So if meeting, because it's a Zoom meeting and it may over by 40 minutes, so you have to rejoin, okay? If we are... If we couldn't finish, so you can rejoin up. I will tell you anyways.
Okay, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Well, I actually went there and I tried to understand the bot itself.
Right.
So I've almost understood everything. I'm only left with one thing to understand.
Okay.
Like, how am I going to plug this thing, the positive and negatively charged wires into the motor?
Okay. So you can do it anyways, you know, it doesn't matter, but you can experiment with that. What would happen if you do it?
No, sir, I've tried getting them in, but I'll show you.
Is it okay if we discuss towards the end? Because then other kids may not understand because they may not be knowing it, right? So at the end, what we'll do? We'll discuss about your questions, queries. Is that okay?
Sure.
Yeah, thank you. So you can see my PPT also, right? Presentation you can see?
Yes, sir. Very yes, sir.
So we are going to make this.
Yeah. So what you see on PPT that we are going to make today. So that's a very simple bot. But it's fun to build. If you haven't built anything.
What will they do?
It will do nothing. It will just roam around here and there. It will just, and while moving around, it will draw on your white paper. If you put some paper down, then it will draw circles. Mm-hmm.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, is it okay to use
a plastic
cup?
Yes, that's fine. It should be lightweight, that's it.
Sir, I don't have button and the cell makes one. I have this type of.
That is also okay.
So, So I can use a button with it.
Yes, you can do that. Also, if you have connectors and while running it, you can plug and disconnect. That is also possible. So without switch also you can do it, but you have to be little careful.
I don't have, sir.
Okay, no problem. Okay, now it's 11. So we will get going, okay? So good morning, everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, now you can be on mute, okay? And then let me speak. Okay, if you have any questions, you can ask anytime. Okay, so let's start. Okay, so today we are going to make, this is a very simple bot, okay, which I call it a draw bot. And there are many versions of it, okay? But we'll understand what is a robotics, what is a bot, okay? And why it is important that you start building it now so that you can build more advanced bot in future. Okay, so today is a very special day for us, right? I know it's a holiday for everyone because of the Mahatma Gandhi Jayanti and Lal Bahadur Shastri Jayanti. But we should understand who are they, what they did for us, okay? But let's not go into that. But I would like to give you two quotes from these two leaders. So what Gandhi said once is the future depends on what you do today. Okay, so you are all young minds and you must be doing something, no? Right? So my kids also play here and there. They play games online and they also study. Similarly, you must be doing the same thing. So what you will do today, it's your future, right? So you are a future of India. So you have to remember that whatever you do, you are doing today, that is something which will shape your future as well as future of India, okay? So that's the first statement for today's session. And the second one is from Lal Bahadur Shastri was Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan. Okay, so he was the second Prime Minister of India after independence. And he believed that our soldiers and our farmers are the pillars of economic development, okay? So whatever you will do in future, okay, you become scientist, you become soldier, or you become, you know, IT expert, you become robotic expert, whatever you become, some of you become teacher. So we have to see how we can help these two pillars, okay? Our soldiers as well as our farmers. So if your inventions can help the soldiers, can help the farmers, it will also help India to grow in a big time. Okay, so we have to learn from these two great leaders. I am also trying to learn from them by reading their codes or by reading their books. Okay, so we are celebrating their Jayanti today. So that's the occasion, you know, we are doing this. Okay. So let's move to the safety factors, okay? Because you all are young, so there is a possibility that you don't know many things about electricity, electronics. So you, whatever you are doing, you have to consult with some elder folks, okay? Whether would be your parents or your sister, brothers, or you can chat to me also on WhatsApp if you feel like. So you always make sure that you are not doing anything without consulting your parents, elders, right? Because there could be a fire hazard, okay? That's the reason we are saying this, okay? That can, you know, unnecessary make some nuisance and they will not allow you to do further experiments, okay? Because during experiment, there is a possibility that you make mistake, right? But that is okay, but you have to take care while doing these experiments, okay? So always try to do with the supervision of your parents and elders. The second thing is whenever you use a knife or glue gun or solder iron, so those are very, you know, can cause a trouble sometimes if you don't handle it well. So you always make sure you are taking help from your elders, okay? Till you become expert in handling those, okay? So many of you may be very young, many of you may be, you know, elder, you can handle those. Yes.
So I don't have glucagon. Can I use?
No, that's okay. Yeah, that's okay. Glucagon is not necessary. I'm just telling you the, because these instruments you can buy it. Maybe you will buy it soon. So that's, I'm just trying to tell you. Okay, you have to take care.
Okay, sir.
Never keep your batteries on or your instrument on. It is unnecessary. It will waste your energy as well as it can cause trouble also. So you always make sure you disconnect battery whenever you are done with the usage. Okay. Never play with the electricity supply. What does that mean? Your home electricity is having high voltage and high current. That can cause a lot of trouble. Okay. So never play with that. For while doing the robotics experiments, okay? Unless and until you know what you're doing with your parents, okay? So these are few factors you should remember, factor of safety or the, you can say, rules before experimenting. So you're not, nobody will stop you for experimenting, but you have to take a due care, okay? Then quickly we'll move, I will not do my introduction quickly, I will do it later because it will take time a bit. Okay, then what we'll do? Okay, so let's jump to robot. Okay, so today we are going to make a draw bot. Okay, it's a very simple bot, but there are different types of robots, right? You must have seen already on movies, on TVs, on your internet. Okay, so robot is nothing but as a programmable machine, you can say. Okay, you program it and it will do the task repetitively or maybe intelligently also nowadays. Okay, so there are different types of bots. So you should understand robots are made for helping humans. Okay, and then assist in a work which is maybe dangerous to humans, it is not possible for humans to do it. That's where robot comes into picture and they will help us. Okay, so let's jump into the different types of bots. It's very interesting, okay? It's very interesting to understand. And I got this from one of the magazine called Make Magazine, okay? Which is US-based magazine, which is available online. If you get opportunity, just try to see if you can get it, okay? It is very useful for maker like you, okay? So this is a fun way of classifying robots, okay? So they say that, okay, humans are also robots, you know. Can you believe that humans are also robots? Who will believe that humans are robots?
Sir, I will not
believe. Ritvik here.
Yeah, okay. So we can believe, right? Okay. So we can say humans are, you know, because humans do many things differently. They are very skillful because we evolved from the monkeys, right? So humans are, you know, higher version of bots, you can say. But fun way, okay? Humans as robots. So worker who are working in a factory, they do a task continuously, the same task, you know, repetitively. So they are kind of become a bot, right? They keep on doing same thing again and again. They get fatigue out of it, but, you know, that's another part of it. So workers are kind of a robots. Then transgenic, it's a type where you can see resemble with the Spider-Man, okay? Because you know, right? Spider-Man is actually a human, but some experiment happened, spider bite him, and then he becomes a spider, right? He start waving the web here and there. So that kind of a human is called transgenic, okay? Because there is a genetic change in his body, and that's why he is able to do it. The third one is mutant. Okay, mutant, you must have watched the X-Men movie, right? There were different humans who have got supernatural powers. Okay, obviously these are very fictitious characters, but these are fun way to look at it. Okay, what are how the creator had thought about this kind of humans or robots? Okay, so we have seen workers, we have seen transgenic, you have seen mutant. Okay, so these are human type of robots. Let's move next. Then there are cyborgs. So those are nothing but with machines. Okay. So you must have seen a prosthetic. Prosthetic is nothing but a type of helping. So whoever amputees, you know, right, disabled folks like whoever not having arms or legs, scientists have developed prosthetic for them so that it will assist them to do their work. Okay, so if you have seen let me keep everyone. Okay, so prosthetic is nothing but a robotic arm or robotic leg, right? Then it is called prosthetic. Okay, then there is called endoskeletal. Okay, endoskeletal robot. So it is nothing but anything which is inside your body. Okay, and that is act as a kind of robotic arm or robotic leg. Okay, but it looks like a real hand or real leg, but inside there are robotic parts. But since it is embedded inside your body, it is called endoskeleton. Okay, then there is an exoskeleton. Exoskeleton means outside your body. So Iron Man suit, right? So Iron Man doesn't have anything inside his body. He just put on his suit and then he becomes a supernatural Iron Man. Okay, and he gets more power. Okay, so this is called exoskeletal because it's outside the body. Okay, so this is again a kind of a bot, you know, called cyborg. Then comes the software robot. Okay, those are not physical robots, but they are brainy robots like artificial intelligence. Those are robots which who are like brain of human. Okay, they do multiple tasks, do multiple calculations at a given in a microseconds. Okay, so our computer is also kind of a robot, you can say, because it can does many things automatically, right? Calculations, then your recording, playback, everything. Okay, so that is a kind of calculator. So those are nothing but programs which are soft programs. You cannot see them, but you can view them via output devices. So this is a one type of robot. Okay, so artificial intelligence is coming up big time now, and people are using it everywhere nowadays. So we will discuss maybe later session whenever we have it on artificial intelligence. Then comes a mechanical robot. Yes.
I didn't understand the difference between the exoskeleton and the endoskeleton.
Okay. So let me repeat. So what endoskeletal means? Endoskeletal means the part which is a mechanical part or whatever robot which is inside your skin. Okay, inside your body. And it will help you to do many things very powerful, you know, right? You might have seen, I don't know, many of you may not have seen I, Robot movie from Will Smith, okay? If you get a chance, so you can watch that I, Robot movie where he has got his arm, but his arm was robotic, okay? So with this arm, he can do many things, right? So it is endoskeletal means it is inside your skin, it is inside your body. And when you say exoskeletal, it is outside the body, like Iron Man. Okay, Iron Man is somebody who is a human, but he when puts on his suit, then he becomes Iron Man. Yeah, Atharva, you want to say something?
Yeah, sir, I actually wasn't sure. Like, I got to talk confused between the two. So, like, since we're talking about fictional stuff, yes. Sort of. So, I was seeing this series called The Clone Wars. It's a Star Wars series.
Okay.
So, in that, one of the villains, actually, half of his body is robot. Like, there's a fourth of his body is robot. So, would that be considered his endoskeletal part or his exoskeletal part? Because he can't survive without that part.
Yeah. So, you can consider him as a cyborg. Means it's a mixture of endoskeletal, exoskeletal, right? So you might have seen I don't know which cartoon you see. Three Titans. You must be seeing Teen Titans.
Yes, okay. Sir.
Yeah, there is a cyborg, right? So he's a half human, half skeleton, you know, like cyborg, right? So those are a mixture of this all stuff. Okay, so you can call them cyborgs, you know. That's what I would say. Obviously, these are fun facts, sure. But you know, many times what happens is many scientists look at this future vision of robots, right? And then they see, okay, can we make this happen? And you must have seen that there are folks like in USA who are trying to build Iron Man suit. Okay, so Iron Man doesn't, it wasn't existing, right, in real. It was just imaginary thing. They built a movie, but people started building in real time. You know, they started building those jets, okay, and then they can fly around, you know, things like that. So these are way also you can look at it as a inspiration, right, while building a bot or robots. Okay, Dhruv, you want to ask something?
So we will start making.
Yeah, we'll start making soon. Yes. We will have time now. So what we'll do, we will finish this. There is only one slide now and we are done. Okay, then the last types of robots are mechanical robots. Okay, like humanoid robots. You must have seen Sophia. Okay, so that's a kind of humanoid. Then there are creatoroid, so which are nothing but mimic the creature, natural creatures. Okay, those are also robots. Then there are industrial robots. Industrial robot means the robotic arm, right? So those are there. So these are mechanical based robots. Also, there are scientific robots, which you must have seen going on Mars, right? Perseverance robot. So that Perseverance rover. So that is there on Mars, right? So that is a kind of scientific robot. Then there are household robots, which are like vacuum cleaners. They automatically go around the house and cleans your house. Then there are medical robots, which do a surgery. So it assists doctors to do very accurate surgery without any problem. Okay. Then there are toys, mechanical toys, right? So those are also kind of robot, because they do let's say jumping toy, right? It can do that jumping action every now and then based on, you know, if we have, you know, that's kind of, you can also call them a bot, you know. Okay, anyone want to ask anything on this classification? Anybody like to add something? Maybe we can spend 1 or 2 minutes there. Otherwise, we'll start building. Okay, so now,
Sir, these different types of robot has specifically different types of job also, right?
Yes.
So is there like any option, like if there was a robot that cooks and there was a robot that do surgery, is it like any possible way that they can learn others' job, or they will just do the specific? Because if we like want like a surgery robot to do a cooking job, so will it like learn and do it, or we have to like, or it cannot just do it?
Right. That's a good question, Arush. So what happens is that because, you know, like medical surgery, right, it's a very very critical, right, for, because you operate a human, and if you do something wrong, it can, you know, cause a problem for a patient, right? So you have to make a very accurate, when I say very accurate, that means it should do its job without fail, 100% every time it will do, right? So that's accuracy you require while having that robot in your surgery, or while doing surgery. But when, let's say, you want to clean your house, okay, and your bot doesn't clean one side of a floor, but that is okay, right? Because it's not causing much of a trouble to you. But yeah, that accuracy is not required. So when you say, I want to build something which can do, let's say, cleaning, which can do housekeeping, which can do kitchen cooking, or it can do surgery. So if you want to try to build such a robot, which is possible, maybe possible in future, then you have to spend a lot of time, right, training it with the different functionality. And it might not do a job very accurately for what it is being made. So surgery robot, let's say you try to make him clean, it can do it. You know, it's not possible that it can do it. But because of the additional functionality which you have added, it can create more complexity in that robot, and it may not do a job like surgery, which is his primary job, right? So like, for example, let's say you are a doctor as a human, and then you've been asked, no, now you repair the car. You may not do it because you haven't learned that skill, right? As an engineer or as a human. But for a robot, obviously that limit is not there because he can learn many things. Yes, but sir. Right now it is not, they don't do it like that.
Okay, sir.
All right, so let's not spend more time. So if in case our meeting gets over, you can rejoin back.
I don't know who, but it showed a message that the time is extended to unlimited.
Is it?
Yeah, like,
yes, sir.
Yes. It seems to be as if you paid for pro.
Yeah. But I haven't paid that. I don't know. They must be happy that you guys have joined the session. That's why
they had that before. Me and my cousin, we've actually had that same before.
Okay. All right. So let's move to, what we are going to make today is a drawbot. Very, very simple bot. It's based on a vibration. Okay. So what we need is a glass, paper glass or plastic glass is okay. Okay. Let's have it a bigger one. Okay. Smaller one is also okay. Then we required a masking tape if you have, or solo tape, that is okay. A cello tape. Then you need a double-sided tape. You need a battery, 9-volt, or you have casing which can contains like 1.5-volt batteries, like through, I think, show. So that is also okay. Then you need a motor.
Or will a high watt?
Yeah, that would work. That would work.
Battery, though? High watt battery?
Yes.
Sir, how many motors do we need?
We need only one.
Okay, sir.
Okay, but yeah, initially we will do with one, but if you want to try a different way on your own, you can do it. Okay, so this is just a sample one. Then we need a fan. Okay, if you don't have a fan, but let's have a fan because we don't have right now anything else. But I will tell you what else you can use. Okay, then either you will have.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, can I use this type of fan?
Let me see. Okay. Who was showing Dhruv? Yeah. You can do that. Yes, you can do that. You can use that.
Thank you.
Okay. Then you can also have this battery holder. But if you don't have, that is okay. You can use 9-volt battery connector. Yeah. So that is also fine. Okay. This is something which I would recommend. If you get a chance, you buy this because it's very handy. Yeah. Okay. So whoever has
it,
I have that.
Yeah.
I have that.
Yes. So if you don't have, that is okay because we can build with the.
I don't have computer.
Yeah, that's okay. Then we need 4 sketch pens. Right?
Like, sir, this. What we have to do from it?
Sir, I chose 3, but
yeah, so that's okay.
We have to use like 4 small sized ones.
Sorry, can you come again?
Either big size ones, sir.
Either big size ones okay, or we have to use a small one?
No. Big size is okay. No problem.
Okay, sir.
Okay, and then yes.
Sir. I have like two batteries, sir. Two only.
Two batteries?
No, two. These are 2 clips I have.
That's okay. That's good. Okay, now what we have to do is we have to take a cup, get a masking tape or a cello tape, and then we have to put 4 sketch pens. If you have 4, or if you have 3, that is also okay. We just have to put it like this, you know, and then you have to stick with the masking tape. So let me do that. So you can do that at the same time. So I will keep like this. The part which is below the cap should be at bottom, because we have to open that cap later on. So you have to, but while not using it, you have to keep the cap on a sketch pen. And then I will fix it. Okay, like this. Similarly,
yeah, I have a long sketch pen. Can I use the long one?
Yeah, you can use long one also. It will go like till the top, right? That's okay. You can, but you have to make sure that the cap, below cap side.
Sir, we have to do it on four side.
Yeah. Do it on four because it gives more stability. But if you have three, you have to do some balance side. You know, later on it may fall down. So you have to remove it and then you have to see how to balance it out. But four would do. Or three would also work. Okay, so once I edit, then it can.
Sir, can I use this cup?
Yes, Shriti, Ishita, you can do that. Use that. Cup is just for holding your sketch pens and all components together. Okay, once that is done, I hope everybody did that.
No, sir.
Okay, keep doing. Okay, whoever has done it, then they can draw some funny faces on one side of it, you know, like a creature. I don't know, whatever you imagine, you know, whatever you want to call your bot. Okay, make the face of the creature.
Sir, mine is done.
Okay, very good. Shall I move ahead?
Yes.
No, sir.
Quick. Okay, anyways, I am recording this session, so I will hopefully send you all a link afterwards. Okay, then what we have to do is we have to, okay, now since you have, mostly folks have a 9-volt connector like this, and most of them don't have crocodile clip, okay? So what they can do is they can directly connect these wires to the motor, okay? Any side would do, okay? One side could be black, one side should be
red. Sir, I'm not connected. Because I have battery button, sir.
Okay, so you don't have wire attached to it?
Sir, I have.
Okay, so you can connect that Okay, so first I will show you for this particular connector, and later on I will show you for crocodile cube. Okay, watch carefully. So what will I do? So how I will connect if I don't have crocodile connector? I will just, there are holes to the terminals. So there are terminals like this. Those are copper terminals. Okay, you have to take care while using that. Okay, then what you have to do is we have to pass this wire through the hole there. Okay, there is a hole on this terminal. So there are two terminals, and on two terminals I can connect wire by pulling the metal part of the wire through the terminal. Okay, and then I can just rotate. Don't apply too much pressure, because those connectors are very lightweight and that can break. Okay, just through the hole, and then just twist around. Okay, so this is how I will do. And then what I'll do, so because those wires are not would move around, so I will take a masking tape again, and then fix it around, you know, because it will not move then, like this. Okay, so what will happen because of this, your wire would not come out from the terminal, otherwise your motor or your fan would stop working in between. So what you have to do, you have to put a cello tape, or you have to put masking tape around the wires so that it will not come out. Okay, is that okay, everyone? Are you with me?
Sir, I have a doubt. Yes, sir. When I connect, some voice comes, I don't know why, with the wire.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, so can you see me? And when I connected both the terminals, some voice came just now. I don't know how.
Okay, but your battery
is there. Yes, sir, it's coming.
No, but battery is there already?
Yes, sir, it's there.
No, remove the battery. Remove the battery.
Okay. Okay, sir.
Okay, while connecting, remove the battery. Okay. Otherwise, that's why voice is coming, because yes, motor starts rotating, right? So what I have done, I haven't connected battery here. I just put wires. Okay. So this is the first way of doing connection with motor and connector. So there is a second way of it. In case you guys have crocodile clips, right? Like this. Let me remove it just to show you how to do it. So usually what happens, you might have crocodile clips. Many of you have crocodile clips. So, okay, like this, you have the connectors, and then you have crocodile clips like this.
Sir, can we use this also now, rather than a battery holder?
Who is that? Let me see.
Ritvik Jain.
Yeah, Ritvik. That's what we are doing, right, with this. You see? We are done that way only, see?
Okay, sir.
Right? So I am directly connected the wires to the terminals of a motor, and then put a masking tape around. All right?
Okay, sir.
Okay, now few of you have got crocodile clips like this. Okay. So what happens is, let me adjust my camera. Okay, so many of you has got crocodile clips like this. So remove the one cap from crocodile clip like this. Okay. And then since this is a black, so I will get the black wire from my 9-volt terminal and put the cap inside that black wire of my connector. Okay, like this. And then there is a metal part I will put from bottom. You see, there is a hole. There is a hole here in crocodile clip. I will, from the bottom, I will take the wire out, the metal part of the wire, like this, you see? And then put the cap on top of it. Because cap was there in a wire, right? Previously I have connected. So I will just push the cap. Okay, like this. So it becomes fixed. Okay. I will show you for red one again. It's the same thing. what we have to do is we have to take the cap out for one. In similar direction, I have to insert inside the wire of the connector, you know, like this. You see? And then there is a hole of to the there is a hole you see on crocodile clip. You just have to insert a metal part from bottom to the top. You see, like this. I hope everything is clear to you. And then when I pull this, push this cap again, so what it will do, it will press this wire between this metal part and a cap. That's why it will not come out. Okay, like this. You see, now it is very fixed. Now both are very fixed. Yeah. Okay. So if you have this particular crocodile clip, then you can use like this. Okay, or you can use like this. Now with the crocodile clip, what is the easy part is that you can just, you don't have to do anything. You just have to clip it, you know, like this to the terminals. And it become very easy to connect, disconnect. Okay, that's why crocodile clip is very handy. Not with this experiment, with any other experiments also, crocodile clips are very useful. Okay, so if you can use the crocodile clip like this, then it, or you find it somewhere in on a store, just buy it. I would recommend you to buy it, at least 2-3 pairs, so that it, you can use it later on also. Okay, so what will I do now is, I have to put the motor on one side of the pot like this. I have to stick it here. Okay, so this shaft, so motor has got this one. So this is called shaft. Okay, this is called motor shaft because it will rotate. Okay, when you provide the battery electric current, then it will rotate. So I have to stick it on this paper cup. So I would use a two side battery.
Yeah. After doing like this, the clip, we have to do the clip in both sides, sir.
Yes, yes. Both the sides, red one is for red wire, black one is for black wire, like this. You see, not on both sides. You can connect wire only to one side of one clip. You say, so you cannot connect both to the one clip only. You have to have two clips and with same color. Color wouldn't matter actually, where which side you are putting the color, but it's good to have representation proper. So I have connected a red crocodile clip to red wire, black crocodile clip to black wire. Okay.
Sir, I don't have the double-sided tape, so.
So you
can. Can I use the masking tape?
Yes, yes, yes. You can just wrote, just like we have put the sketch pen. You can do that way.
Okay.
So one, what I have done is I have put a masking tape at one side, opposite to the where the connectors are. I want to put the connectors. Opposite side means on front side, so that's why I have put double sided tape on other side. So I just would stick it like this. You see, everyone do that.
Sir, can you wait?
Yes, yes, I can wait. Don't worry, we are recording this. Okay, so what will happen? I will send you recording also. And then you can watch it again and again. If you don't understand right now, that's okay. You know, you just keep observing how we are doing it. Okay. So,
what happened? After putting the both clips, what we have to do?
Clipping the both clips, right? You have done that. So don't.
Yeah.
Okay. So because you have got clips, so what you have to do is you have to directly put battery. So the people who are directly got clips, so they can put directly the motor like this. You don't connect anything right now. So the student.
Yeah, I don't have clips. What?
No, if you don't have a clips, then other way. So I have shown you, right? This one is coil. Got it? Okay, I will make two bots now. Just a minute. Okay. okay, what I'll do for others who has got like, you know, battery crocodile wheels, I will just connect the motor like this. And for the students who got who does not have a crocodile clip, they can directly connect connector to the motor and then put the motor on one side of a bot. Okay. And then, okay, shall I move?
No, sir. For us. I have crocodile clip. What do I have to do, sir?
I have shown, right? You have fixed the crocodile clip to the connector. Have you?
Which connector, sir?
You see your screen?
Yeah.
Yeah,
so I have connected like this.
Okay, very good. And you, so now you just put a motor like this, a simple motor. The connector are outside. You just stick it to one side, just like.
Yeah, I have done.
Okay, very good. All right, and then what we have to do is we have to use the battery to again stick it. So again, use a double-sided tape. And put it on one side of a battery like this. And opposite side of a motor, right? Motor is on one side. So let's say it's on right side, then I put on left side because it becomes, and towards the down side mostly because it becomes stable. Robot becomes a little bit stable. You see? For the people who has got battery connector, or so they can, what they can do is they can put the crocodile clip, with the crocodile clip, they put the battery holder or battery directly on one side, and then crocodile clips can be connected directly to the motor.
Sir, can you like one time again show that how do we connect this wire with the crocodile clips?
Yeah, I can do that again. Just a minute. Okay, let me remove it. Okay, so the crocodile clips comes as this. Okay, remove the one cap. Okay, and then okay. In the same direction, there is a hole.
So after connecting, what we have to do?
Wait, let me show this. Okay, then you put the wire back inside the wire. Okay, this cap,
okay.
The smaller side should go towards it first. And then bigger side is outside. Then there is a hole for a crocodile clip, okay? There is a hole. Okay, so wire should come not from the top, from the bottom. So this metal part of the wire should come from the bottom through the hole and come on the top. Okay, like this. So see,
yeah.
The metal part coming okay. From on top, and then you fix this yeah. Gap. Yeah, just a minute.
So after doing like this, what we have to do?
You have to stick it to the one side.
Okay, sir.
Okay, and toward the bottom of it, bottom of the bot, not on the top of the bot, because it's a heavy, little heavy compared to motor. So we have to give a stability to your bot. That's why we are towards the ground, we are sticking the battery, not towards the top side. Okay, and now I can check whether so when I connect the connector, you can see the sound of a motor. Okay, so you don't connect right now because it will waste your battery. Everyone done this? Have you connected motor? Have you connected battery and?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Can you wait?
Yes, sir.
Do you want me to repeat anything?
Sir, can you wait?
Yes, yes, I can wait, yes. Okay, whoever has got, whoever has already done, they can create an antenna or the... You know, like a funny thing for your bot. like I have this you know, straws. I can keep on top of it like this, you know, and make it a little funnier. So whoever done the already the part and they are waiting, they can make it little bit create a, you know, they can give some personify the robot, you know. So make like human or maybe creator, some creature, you know, like alien.
Sir, instead of a motor, can I use a vibrating motor?
Pardon?
Can I use a vibrating motor?
If you have vibrating motor, yes, you can use, but how big is that?
The same size of the DC motor.
Oh, okay, okay. So you understand, right? When you use the vibration motor, it should give enough vibration to move your bot, right?
Yes, sir. I made one.
Oh, very good. Okay, let me know if you are okay to move forward, yeah?
Yes, sir.
Shall I move?
Yes, sir.
So,
yes.
Okay. So, I have skipped it. Now, from clip, what I have to do from clip?
Okay, what you have done? You have put a clip? Yeah, Sumit, okay, very good. Sumit, that's good, sir. Good, yeah.
Thank you, sir. Can you please repeat this step, sir?
Which one? The connector one or which one? So what we have done is, we have put, initially we have put all sketch pens. Later on, what we have done, the student who don't have a crocodile clip, what they can do, they directly pin the connector directly to this terminal of a motor. And then, so that, and you can put around a sellotape or a masking tape so that wires would not come out. So there is a hole for a terminal. So you have to insert inside that terminal, the wire from the connector like this. Okay, and keep it at one side. And then what you have to do, you have, on the other side, you have to put only battery with the double-sided tape. Okay, that is it.
Okay, sir.
And the students who has got the crocodile clip, they can directly plug they can directly stick the motor at one side without anything, and then on other side they can directly put their battery on other side. If you have battery, put battery. If you have battery holder, put battery holder, and on top of it, just connect your connector with crocodile clip. All right. So you both the students should have. So what is good about battery crocodile clip is that even if you connect this crocodile clip to battery directly, in the sense with the connector, you don't have to connect to motor. So your motor will not run, okay? Because you haven't connected the connectors to the motor. And the students who don't have crocodile clip, they should not put this on top, because it will rotate your shaft of a motor, or it will start motor. Okay. Once that is done, we have to put a fan on a top of a shaft or a motor. Okay, just insert that. Okay.
Sir, I've done this already.
Very good.
So I have also done it.
Very nice. Very nice. Very good. Very good. Everyone, whoever did it, good. Good job.
So now, what we want to do?
Okay. What we have to do now is, you have to test your bot now. Okay. Now what I have to do is, I have to connect the connector to the 9-volt battery and keep your hand or fingers away from the fan, because fan will rotate very fast.
So okay. It's moving.
Ah, it's moving, obviously. it will move, right? Because of the mechanical motion. So now, can anyone tell me why it is not moving for me? Why it is not?
Because I think so you have not put the tape on that.
On what? So on fan. There is nothing on fan, and when I'm connecting my 9-volt connector to the battery, it's just not moving around. It is just not moving around. Okay, now I will do one trick. Okay.
Sir, is it because of heavy weight or something?
No, there is another
concern. Can you wait for a second?
Yeah, I can wait. Okay, when I'm putting the motor fan like this on top of motor, it is not moving. So I need to find out why it is not moving.
Sir, I didn't understand what we have to do with the crocodile clip.
Who is this? Yeah, who is this?
When I put the crocodile clip, it's not working.
Okay. See, you have to watch the video again, beta. Okay. And then you see what mistake you are making. Yeah? Okay. I will share the video so that you can go again, you know, step by step. I will try to see after our, you know, class. Once everybody is done, we will check. Okay, but you try to find out, you know, you are watching, right? Since the starting, then you can understand where what is going wrong with crocodile clip. Have you connected wires properly? If wires are not connected properly, it may not carry the current from the battery to motor. That's why the motor is not.
So are you also going to connect it to the switch?
No, switch is not required right now. If you but if you want to try, you can do that. Samit, you want to ask anything?
Okay, sir,
then how will the bot move?
How will the bot move, right?
Yes.
Okay, so the bot to move. So what I have done is, you see these two fans. One fan is a plane and it's a very symmetric. The other fan, I have put some weight on it, on one side of the blade. It could be, you can put double-sided tape also with some weight on it, right? So what I can do is, you can cut a double-sided tape, make it two or three like this. Make it a big one, like this. And then on one side of the blade, stick it like this. Can you do that? And then put on top of motor again. Be very careful, okay? With the fan. You have to put the fan very tight because it can fly, okay?
Sir,
and when I put, you see, it starts moving.
Sir, could you share the trick again?
Okay, what we did is, we took a fan and on top of one blade, we have put some double-sided tape, so that this fan becomes not symmetric, because it is having weight at one blade and other blades don't have any weight. Okay, the weight is because of this double-sided tape. We have put two double-sided tapes on top of each other, and that's why this fan becomes imbalanced. Okay.
My fan is not working.
Your fan is what?
Sir?
Who is asking that? Can you name yourself?
Sir, Samit.
Samit, yeah, Samit.
Sir, my fan is not running.
Huh. Yeah, Samit.
Sir, where we will stick the weight on?
Sir, my cup is not moving.
Yeah, wait, beta. Yeah, Samit, what do you want to ask? Sorry.
Sir, where,
Here, where we have to stick the weight on upper side or lower side of the fan.
So you can experiment. You can put it on top. You can put it on bottom. You have choice. Your own choice. I have put it on a top.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Arya, you want to ask anything?
I have a doubt. But where did you put the weight? Like, I did not put the weight in my fan. The boat is not moving.
So when you put a fan, so you have to imbalance the fan. So that's why you have to put weight on only one blade.
Okay, so I'll do that.
Okay. Okay. Who had a problem? Who was that? Who asked that my fan is not rotating or something? You have to check.
My fan also is not rotating.
Fan is not rotating.
So my cup is not standing.
Okay. So you have to find out why it is not standing. So either you have used three sketch pens because of the weight of this battery, right? It falls like this. Okay. So it could happen with you. So you have to change the position of a battery to see that if you move here and there, can it balance? Okay. Try it out. Okay. We have to make it balance.
Okay,
sir. Sir, we technically made it. Mm-hmm. But then, like, now I have to find a way so that when I want it to work, it will work. And then when I want it to stop,
okay,
it stops. Like, it's actually working.
So, your battery or maybe connections are loose. That's why?
No, sir, it is working. But then, like, I need to find a way to stop it when I have to stop it and let it move when I have to let it go.
Okay. So right now, what is happening? We haven't used any switch right here in this bot. So what I just connect it when I want it to work like this. Then when I don't want, I will remove the connector. Yeah, I will just remove the connector.
For you, it can be harmful for the bot.
Sorry.
Sir, but then wouldn't that be harmful for the bot?
Hopper for the. Hopper bot, you are saying?
Sir, like, but would it be like harmful or bad for the bot or anything?
No, I am not getting your question. Can you come again? How to stop it? You mean?
But would it not be harmful for it?
Okay. Yeah. So what happens is if you don't have switch, right? Only you have to make sure that you aren't continuously connected your battery to the motor. Otherwise, it will drain your battery. Obviously, you can do, right? Improvisation. So whoever has done already, what they can think of, they can. Can you put a switch in between if you don't have switch? In the sense, like for this particular board, I have got switch here. Okay, this battery holder already got switch, so I have option to stop it. But for this bot, I don't have any option unless and until I remove this connector. Okay. So I have to go and I have to remove it. So it's not very easy way to remove it, you know, while it's working. But yeah, then we have to find out way to connect the switch somewhere in between. And then it will help you to switch on or switch off. That's a one way. Or we have to get something like this, which will have switch inside. And then it will help. Or you have crocodile clips, so you can just plug one of the crocodile clips and it should work. Okay. With crocodile clip, what happens is you just connect the crocodile clip to the two terminals, one side black, one side red. And then let's say it starts working. Let me use this. Okay, now when the good thing about this bot is about, because everybody don't get the things which I have, right? Because you have to, you know, don't get in a market very easily. So there is a switch already. Okay, so I can switch on, switch off like this. So it doesn't have anything, but still it will move. Okay, and then either if you don't have switch, then you can just remove this one side of crocodile and it will stop. Okay. So this is not very sophisticated way to stop it or start it, but yeah, just to start with.
Sir, I have a doubt. With what things you can give the weight to the fan? Like, I don't have the tape which you have.
Okay. So
how should I give the weight?
Yeah, if you have glue gun, then put a glue gun, one dot or one spot of a glue gun, or
you don't have glue gun also.
Okay, that's fine. Then you might have a small screw or nut around house.
Yes, sir.
Okay, you can do, you just stick it to the one side and cello tape it, or use double side tape, masking tape around it. And you make sure that it will not fly around, because that may harm somebody. Not very big way, but unnecessary. It should not fly around.
Okay, sir.
So, Ritvik, you is he not standing still, or what is it?
Its fan was just moving and now it's not moving.
Okay. Maybe connections, you have to check connections with the motor.
Yes, sir.
And the battery may drain because we are not using any resistor. So what happens is it will drain the battery also.
Yeah, that's why I think so. It's not moving.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Now it's moving. The fan is now moving. Now,
have you put a weight? Have you put a weight?
Yeah, I have put the double-sided.
Yeah, and battery on one side.
Sir,
don't let it fall like
sir.
That. Yes.
Sir, I made it fully.
Very good. Is that Dhruva?
Yes, sir.
All right. Very nice. It's working. So what you have to do? Okay. Well, the one thing we have forgot, that you have to remove the this thing, right? You have to remove the sketch pen caps.
Yeah, I know that, sir. Okay. I tried it. It is working nicely.
Mm-hmm. So it will mostly draw circles around. Yeah.
One is my drawing dots.
Okay, because it's jumping up and down now. That's why it's drawing the dots.
Yes, sir.
Lines.
Tap tap tap.
Yeah, actually it drains the, because some batteries, some motors take a lot of power from the battery, and then it drains very quickly. So just take care of that. But this is just for learning the first bot. If you haven't made it, then congratulations, you made your first bot now. Yeah, Arya, you want to ask anything?
Bye.
So I want to show you, so now it's working, can I?
Yes, you can.
So just a minute.
Okay, whoever wants to show, let me know so that I can make you as a add to spotlight. Yeah, very good.
Can you see?
Yeah.
It's not moving fully. Like, it's just roaming here. It's not so fast.
Right. So you maybe check that. Why it is doing that way, maybe weight is too much, or your sketch pens, right? Those should be very straight, those, so that the movement becomes little this one.
Yes, I'll do that.
Yeah, but very nice. Anyone want to show? Don't worry if you haven't made fully, but you can still show. Okay, now I want to show you a few more things if you are okay. The thing is that once you start building bot, there are many ways you can build the bots, like solar bot like this on a screen. These are made from the solar cell, and behind there is a vibration motors. You get it online. Okay, it can work in a very sunny day. Okay, like this. This uses a mobile vibrator motor like this, the round one, smaller one, and it uses.
Sir, I have made this.
You made similarly.
Sir, what is this?
Yes.
Sir. Yes.
Wait,
who is asking first?
Ritvik,
let Ritvik, you ask first and Dhruv, then you can ask, yeah? Yeah, Ritvik.
I was asking, what is that on the up part?
This one, this is just decorative, this thing. I am using some capacitors and one wire to make it like personified, you know, like a dinosaur.
And what is that? It's like that solar panel.
Yeah, solar cell. Solar panel. You will get it ready made, right? You can get it anywhere. Only thing you need to buy is a motor. This is a vibration motor, which usually get used in a mobile. So we will have one session on this also. I will arrange one sometime. Okay. How to make
sir.
Okay, Dhruv, you want to ask something?
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, what thing we need?
For?
Sir, what thing we need for it?
For solar bot making, you are saying?
Yeah.
Okay, no, I will arrange one session on that. Okay, so you can join that. I will tell you the list of material you will require for that. Is that okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, thank you.
Okay, then there is a vibration bot using only battery and motor also, vibration motor. Okay, like this.
Sir, can you on it?
Yeah, I'm trying to. Wire connections are a little loose. That
switch. Sir, my bot is going brr.
Okay, sir.
Sir, my...
Your bot is going?
My bot is sort of creating a tornado. Bot be like brr.
Okay. Okay, you have to arrange, you have to balance it out a bit.
You have to be in a slightly contained environment, sir. That's the only problem.
Right. Now that's the next challenge for you, right? So this bot doesn't follow.
So it is easy. I know I did it because.
Okay.
Take the heavy thing what is and put it in the back in the corner.
And now it's stationary.
Okay. Okay. Just a minute. Huh?
Oh, it's my table has holes, right? If I take it on a like the balcony or something, it could work fine.
Yeah, you can. So Dhruv, how you arrange your fan? Can you show?
Sir.
Yeah, you like need to put it sideways.
Yeah. How do you stop it? Just plug it
the
out?
Corner.
Ah, okay.
In the corner.
Then
center, I mean. Sir.
Okay. All sir? Right.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, this bot is very interesting. I will make more like this.
All right, very good. But you have to experiment. Okay, don't follow the same thing. You have to. I will tell you what to do next. Yeah. Okay, so what you have to do? You try with three legs sometime. You try with this position of a fan is upside down, right? Vertical. You put it horizontally. Yeah. How it works? Then you put the position of the battery here and there. See how different shape it can draw, because right now you will see that it just draw mostly circles. How you can make it to draw some random shapes, you know? So that kind of experiment you can do with this bot and see what is the perfect way to make it, draw different shapes, right? It just do random thing, right? You should predict how it should draw the things. That if you can do that, it will be like a big experiment. It like you become scientist then.
Sir, we can use also plastic cups, na?
Yeah, you can use plastic cups.
Okay.
All right.
My bot is not working.
Okay. Next time, what we'll do? We will try to create a bot with solar and the bug bot, which I have shown, right? The one on this one. This one is very easy, actually. You see this one, very small one. It's again use vibrator motor like here. You know, it's ready to use vibration motor, 1.5 volt battery, and that's it. Okay, so let's next time you will build this one, yeah? This one on, and then next time we'll build the solar bot. Okay. All right. Okay. So I am done now, students. You have any questions or anything? Oh, I want to show you something interesting. Okay, wait.
Sir, can you show the one's fan and the motor? I'm not able to fix it, actually.
On motor, you mean?
No, sir. Motor, where has it to be stuck? Like.
Okay. So either you can stick it like this vertically, okay? Or if you are troubling, your bot is troubling you and falling down, then you can put it like what, horizontally also, like this.
So it will make the same shapes every time if I put the motor in different shapes.
Like, no, that's what you can experiment. Let's say you put it vertically, what different shape is made. If you put it horizontally, how different shapes it can be. Yeah.
I will try. Thank you, sir.
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, we will cut next project and next to next project, all projects, we will continue in the same group, sir.
Yeah, we'll continue the same group.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, I'll keep you posted. Okay, then. I want to show you something interesting. My lab, I want to show you all. So I want you to create your own lab, okay? To see what are the different things in my lab are. So I have got 3D printer here.
Which
can 3D print anything for me. Like the ways you see on there, you see the robotic arm there, it is 3D printed, okay? So with the 3D printer, I can make anything, okay? So once you get older, then you can buy one. Then I have a Raspberry Pi computer here. You can see the screen and the keyboard. So that's a Raspberry Pi computer I use mostly for my programming. Then I have got this table where I have put.
Sir.
Yeah.
You do take programming class?
I don't take programming class, but I take this bot making Arduino stuff. So we will make it. You know, we'll do it maybe.
Yes.
Yeah. Arya, you want to ask something?
No, that was by mistake. I just lowered.
No problem. All right. So you can build such a lab in your house for yourself. You can have all tools there. Okay. And then it will be handy for you to do experimentation on that table or on that place, right? So that is something I would like to suggest you. And that is it. Yes.
Sir, I cannot. Because in my house, there are 3 rooms and 3 of 3 are full.
Okay. So you have to make in a box or something, you know?
Yes, sir. I will make in my table only.
Okay. Okay, then if you want to look at what I do in my free time, what different things I make, so I'm just pasting some links. You can go through them whenever you get time. And I have a YouTube channel also. Okay. Then I write a blog about different things.
Is your channel name? Yes, sir. What is name?
It's a Harem Maker Lab. Okay, I mean, I'm just pasting the link here. Just.
Sir, yes, sir. Can you repeat again?
Yeah. Okay, and then you can watch. If I make something, you can get there. So there are different experiments I already did. You can see if you can, if you want to make them. If you find them interesting, you can make them yourself. Okay. Or you can ask me also.
So,
yes, yes, Tanvir, you are trying to ask something?
No, sir, I've made a drawing before with my robot. Can I show that?
Yeah, you can. You can. You are welcome.
So can I present my screen for them?
Yes, yes, you can. Shall I allow you? Wait, let me add you to the. Do you want to? Can you share a video then, Tanvir?
So which video?
No, which drawing you made? You can show it. Yeah, you can show it on a video.
So does your channel have the, this experiment, the drawing bot experiment?
Sir, I'm not able to.
Of the part of the class.
No, I will put this recording there. Not right now, but okay. I will.
Sir, can you also share all these links on the WhatsApp group if possible?
Yeah, yeah. Let me do that also.
Sir, I'm not.
So can you do a recap of fixing everything because I missed a little class. Recording.
I will share the recording, beta. I will share the recording so you can watch that.
So where would it be shared?
I will share on a WhatsApp because group. Okay, uploading I'm the on my there. Google Drive.
Sir, I'm not there in that group. Can someone?
Who is that?
This is Kavya.
Kavya Saxena. Okay. Okay, you can ping me on this. You can ask your parents to ping me, so I will add you.
Sir, should I send you my number in the chat directly?
I send you mine, so you can ping me on that. Yeah.
Sir, okay, I made a bot before for that. I have made a video also on that. Can I show?
Can
that?
I? Yeah, you can. I don't share. Have the drawing. Yeah, you can share that. You are on WhatsApp channel, Tanvir.
Yes, sir. I'm in a WhatsApp group.
Yeah, you can share there then. Yeah.
Okay, sir.
All right, everyone. Thanks, everyone, for joining today's session. It was very fun to talk to you.
Thank you so much, sir.
Yeah, welcome. Bye for now and take care. Rest of the day. And
bye, sir. Thank you, sir.
Bye, sir. Thank you.